Oh.
I accidentally changed MIDI device.
Was it fluid synth? Yeah, fluid synth, I don't mean. Oh yeah, so last time I was here, my game blue screened. And I didn't continue, because I was like, you know, it was like almost 6 a.m. or something, so like, fuck it. So here we got some, Temple of Doom shit. Like, this is directly Temple of Doom, reference. Cannibal Witch Doctor. I know Light loves Temple of Doom. I believe that was his favorite Indiana Jones movie. How about you, Ogryth? And anyone else willing to share their opinions in chat? Have you watched Indiana Jones movies? It's your favorite. If you have any. For me, it's a really hard choice. I really did like all of them. Oh, hey, King Dime, coming in with the 420. What's up, man? How you doing? Hot winds of hell. Have you played Ancient Gods 2 yet? Oh shit. Got dark real quick. Downloaded it. Hell yeah, we're playing Pirate Doom for sure. Uh-oh. That's a move. People are very, very mixed on Ancient Gods 2. I personally enjoyed it a lot. A lot of the criticisms people give are pretty valid, though. It's just that a lot of the criticisms are not things that bother me personally. But I can definitely see that, you know, if those criticisms would have been addressed, the DLC could have been a bit, definitely a bit better. God, God, I'm not gonna survive here. I don't even know if I'm going the right way because I just YOLO to the right. God, so many lost souls. It is way too dark in there. Yeah, no worries, I'm not gonna spoil anything. You think the 1 year limit with the plan on Steam? Do you mean to ask, like, if I think it's worth it that they forced to rush it, like, to release it in a 1 year window? Releasing it perfect. I mean, it's hard to say. In general, the quality is there. Like, I really enjoyed myself with the DLC. But I probably think that, you know, especially also because of COVID, if they probably had more time, some things could have maybe been better. But, like, it doesn't necessarily feel rushed, with maybe one or two small things that I feel do feel rushed. But yeah, I think maybe if they wouldn't have forced it in a 1 year window, maybe they could have released it a bit later and had some small changes that could have just made it better. Like, the criticisms that people give are definitely valid. And I also think that some people went in with a lot of expectation. Cyber pirate. Some people went in with a lot of expectations because they've been, like, watching Hugo Martin interviews and stuff. They've watched, like, the trailer and whatnot. I just went in all blind. I literally did not look up any trailer, any video, nothing. I went in absolutely blind. So whenever I saw a new enemy, I was like, oh, cool. And a lot of people have some mixed opinions about new enemies. And it's understandable, because they thought it was going to be something else. So that's just the issue of, like, having expectations versus not having expectations. I mean, the first DLC had one new enemy? The turret? Was there another enemy? Forgot already. I know the turret was a thing. And I'm doing terrible. It doesn't help that I'm on low health. I'm also just curious if there's going to be more DLC, because they haven't announced anything. But considering they did the whole year one thing, I am expecting more DLC. And I love the accuracy on this gun. I wish I had some health. Oh god. What is that bright light? Oh, it was... I think it was, like, shooting at the torch there. I skull system like Halo, and it gives all the expert content to challenge themselves, and they can balance the campaign without like hyping them rather dramatically. I'm not very familiar with Halo, so I don't know exactly what skull system means. But difficulty has also been a very big topic on the new DLC. So it's like a parameter where you can increase the damage. Well, I mean, it's not necessarily that. People are saying like the enemies are too easy or don't do enough damage. It's a bit different when it comes to the balance that people are discussing in Ancient Gods 2. But yeah, it's hard for me to really be specific, of course. I don't want to spoil anything. But yeah, I'm curious to see what your opinion will be. Are you planning to stream it anytime soon? I definitely spent all night last night after my stream. I was just watching like three people stream at the same time because I was wanting to hear their opinions. And again, the opinions were also very mixed from everyone. It is, it's good to hear different opinions. Like, I'm not saying it's good that people have different opinions, but if they do have different opinions, then it's at least good to hear those, because, you know, you don't want to be in an echo chamber where you only listen to your own opinion. I like hearing different perspectives. Cannon. Oh shit. Ooh, this is a fun cannon. Assuming that's rockets. Oh yeah. But yeah, like, you know, when I finished playing it, I was like, yeah, this was good. Absolutely fun, had a good time. Then I opened up Under the Mayo's stream. And, yeah, but based off of his attitude, he had a very strong opinion that I was very surprised about, and then I watched him play through the whole thing and share his opinions, and, you know, he opened my eyes on some things that went over my head that I just didn't notice, and I'm like, yeah, I see that being an issue. But just like I said, like, it went over my head, so it didn't really bother me if I didn't notice it. Because a problem is only problematic to you if you're the one noticing it. If someone else has to point out that problem, it's like, oh, you can see it, but it doesn't bother you. Dead men tell no tales. Oh, did I just find a secret? Hell yeah. Did they fix Blood Punch? I heard people say that they did. But I still had a couple moments myself where I tried to glory kill an enemy and I blood punched him, I believe. I also had a moment where I was gonna, where I was trying to glory kill someone. I just punched him like two times as well, and then it just didn't activate the glory kill. Only after the third try it activated. That was without a blood punch, I believe. So I don't know. I still had issues with it, but people did claim that they fixed it. So maybe it was some other issue that people were talking about. But holy shit, this place looks awesome. I like how they fade into the back. Oh, this is great. I want more Doom mods like this. Just so much creativity and care. Something out of Scooby-Doo. That's pretty nostalgic for me. Is Scooby-Doo on like any TV platform, like, you know, Amazon Prime or a Twitch Prime Video or Netflix or something? Just because I'm like spending so much time watching nostalgic shows. I've been watching Pokemon. I want to watch more Dragon Ball. I've been watching freaking Power Rangers. Been watching SpongeBob. Like, a lot of just shows from when I was younger. For the sake of nostalgia, I just want to feel like I'm a kid again, I guess. Ah, sweet. I had like a list of things I wanted to watch. Digimon was also one of the series I was gonna try again. I watched a ton of that back in the day. Then there was also the Sonic cartoon. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. I also wanna watch Clone Wars. I'm on season 2 somewhere, but I haven't touched that in a while. And Avatar. I've watched Legend of Aang back in the day, which I really enjoyed, and now there's Legend of Korra, which I heard is also good, but some people say it's not as good as Legend of Aang, so I don't know, I might give it a try. Look at this pumpkin, though. Secondary fires kind of makes it like a serious sound cannon. Also, I keep forgetting I have like TNT sticks as well. Didn't that explode? I don't know. I think it did. I didn't hear it. Earthworm Jim. Wait, did that have a TV show? I know it had a video game, which I played, which is also super nostalgic to me. I think you also mentioned Legacy of Kain earlier, like a couple days ago. Soul Reaver, man, I played that demo a lot. I loved that demo, I never got to play it. I do own the Legend of Kain games on GOG. Maybe also on Steam, but I do know I own it on GOG. Oh shit. Look at this, that looks awesome. Swampy thing, this reminds me a bit of Blood now. Yeah, there's like a big Mario 64 door here. You know what game on the PlayStation 2 is also super nostalgic? That I only played a demo version. And probably not a lot of people will have heard of this. Dark Cloud. It's like very Legend of Zelda-esque. It had some kind of weird story about, like, a city getting destroyed by some kind, I don't know if it was a meteor shower or something. But then you get this big open playing area with some caves around it. Or cave dungeons. And then you go inside. And you kill skeletons, and, you know, loot chests. And then you basically get items, you basically get, like, buildings that you're able to place down. You're rebuilding the town. And then there's gonna be, like, NPCs that start appearing, I believe. Backlight. And I sucked at Dark Cloud back in the day because I was just a stupid little kid. But I really love the idea of, like, fighting dungeons and rebuilding a city. One problem, though, about Dark Cloud. Goes, like, I just looked it up now. Oh shit. That's actually a good deal. Normally it went for like 40, but now I'm actually seeing deals. I see a deal for 15 euros. Does PlayStation Store have it? Dark Cloud. Ah, it's on PS4. I might actually buy it on PS4 then. I can show you guys. But yeah, it's on PS4 online store, 15 euros. And, you know, I'd probably have a better resolution playing it on PS4. Alright, have a good bike ride, Ogryth. This game I played the demo of. Frickin' ritual shit going on. There's a lot of stuff here. I barely remember anything of this. But it was very Legend of Zelda-esque. Yeah, gameplay. Open chests and shit. You get cheese. This game, oh man. I loved the demo of this game. Oh, dude, the frickin' memories coming back. Yeah, this is absolutely Legend of Zelda inspired, no questions asked. Like, this is so Legend of Zelda. Just the inventory screen, this screams Legend of Zelda. Yeah, I could have, like, someone signed it for 15 physical, but if it's on the PlayStation Store, I'll get it on there, honestly. It's basically a heavy Legend of Zelda inspired kind of game. On PlayStation 2.
Yellow.
But yeah, it had that neat mechanic of where you rebuild the city. You can place like buildings and shit, I believe. Oh, the music stopped. That means. Oh. Yeah, it's actually interesting. Oh, because Horizon Zero Dawn is also coming to PC. Or I believe it is already on Steam, but if I can get it, if it's gonna be free anyway on PlayStation, that's gonna be a hard choice for me. Gonna have to choose to play it on PlayStation or, like, for free, or play it on PC, but then I'd have to buy it still, so. Tough choice. Gotta get some of that rum. But I'm happy I got Ratchet and Clank. I believe I got all the PlayStation 2 Ratchet and Clank games as well. Unlike, yesterday. Yeah, I'm gonna have to see what's gonna happen. There's gonna be a heavy Steam sale and stuff like that. Well, yeah, I'll pick it up anyway for free. The only other game I've got for free was, I believe Infamous. I don't know if I still have rights to download that, because that was like back on my old PlayStation. I don't know if it's still like actually on my account, probably not. I use my pistols more. Keep forgetting I have them. That's who in Doom switches to the pistol, right? But this pistol is actually pretty useful. Yeah, exactly. I don't have a chain gun yet. This pistol, which is still better, you know, double pistol is better than normal pistol because of the fast rate of fire. But it's not as good as chain gun. Giving a lot of cannonballs as well. So normally we can throw dynamite like that. This thing launches dynamite, which is a lot better. But that looks like a chain gun in there. Oh my god, this weapon rocks. What's these random chests though? Now this is slot 7. Now I'm actually gonna care about TNT pickups. God, this rocks. I need a... I might need a sound effect of Metal Gear Awesome 4. Where a snake is in the Metal Gear and he yells, "This rocks!" And I was also planning forever to put in the roadkill snake sound. There's a lot of sounds I still was going to add. To be reminded. Remind me after the stream, like, I have to add specific sound effects, but you gotta specify which ones. You gotta tell me the roadkill snake, and this rocks, and stuff, and maybe some others that I've previously said I was gonna add. My mind is just too stupid for this shit. I just cannot. I cannot remember anything. Bog. Well, maybe, you know, maybe I'll also be able to read it after I finish the stream. But yeah, hopefully you'll make it. In general, these guns are amazing. Sword, amazing. Double pistols, amazing. SSG, I actually don't use it that much, but it's alright. I like the single shotgun in this one as well. This has got such nice accuracy. This thing is nice. This thing is nice. This thing is nice. This thing is nice. Just the throwable sticks I don't like. I'd be willing to use this as a freaking weapon pack, man. Like, if I wish this could be a gameplay mod. Maybe you can load it as a gameplay mod, I don't know. Don't know if it, what it does with the textures. If it's gonna, like, replace similar textures. Yeah, I'm looking forward to it as well, man. Baron Castle. I should have known that was a trap. That was bad by me. The only thing I don't like is the big flash effects. Gotta be quick. I feel these are gonna open. They didn't open for some reason. Thank you. spinach. Have I gotten a backpack at all yet? I don't think so. I don't know. Yeah, we did get the chain gun. Don't tell me you're so far behind that you're now at the point where I got the chain gun. Cause that was like 10 minutes ago. This is like almost a freaking Russian overkill weapon. Man, these guns are awesome. Funky elevators, better than the ones I make. Is this like copyrighted music? and we'll see what happens when they upload it.
Oh shit.
That's a room clearer right there. Get up there. There we go. Are you gonna make all of these walls and not even the items there? It's a bit disappointing. Oh my god, what? How to kill barons quickly. This. Iron boots. Nice. Oh, that's a lot of kills not done. gecko. Question, like, were you here at when I started playing Pirate Doom today? Ah, too bad. There was a part. That's where I continued, which was like a Temple of Doom reference. So I was like, oh, Light would love this. But sadly weren't there to see it. But hey, I'm assuming you might end up playing this as well yourself. Boom, boom. Steampunk spoder. Shit, where'd that rub come from? Uh-oh. gun is so fun to use. Just spamming small cannonballs and then just having like the option to shotgun blast them. That's good stuff. What was that honk I heard? There it is again. Classic car honk, oh my god. Vibrating caco there. Framerate was a bit fucky, yeah? Beer! Interesting. Whoa, it is where the frame rate is fucking if I look down now. Not a backpack? Finally, we got a backpack. Hell yeah. Took a while, Jesus. Oh, they hit the wine. Ow. Do these guys have like these horns? The arachnotrons? Okay. Oh, spinach, good. Actually needed that. A lot of stuff here. This gun is the best gun ever. Oh. That could also be a sound command. Hey. Don't activate that. What? I could swear I just opened something. What? What? Can I just break this? The hell? Broke it. Fuck. I had no idea what the hell was going on. Oh. Hey, Ogryth, welcome back. Man, you made a quick trip with your bike, man. How was the cycling? We're doing great. I think we got all the weapons now. Including the amazing dynamite cannon. It's pretty funny because, like, it's very rare to actually hear people outside the Netherlands to have a bicycle because it's like a very Dutch thing. Oh, cool. Yeah, I'll do that. This dynamite launcher wrecked. Frame rate is a bit shitty in some parts of this map. Ladies and gentlemen, how to kill an archfile. God. Didn't expect that. I was like, should I shoot the barrels? Nah, it's not gonna be a trap, right? House of Mojo. I hear a munching pinky. Oh, well. God, this mod is constantly being creative without end. That rev's still not dead. That was awkward. That is weird. Oh God. Uh-oh, they can follow me. That is a dynamite launcher indeed. And it is pretty fucking OP. But fun. Definitely feels like a weapon that pretty much belongs in Russian Overkill almost. Up all these armor shards even though I'm already full. Oh god. See what this is doing. Oh hey. Dynamite launcher saves the day. I was about to say, like, where the key would get. Oh. Oh god! Dynamite launcher is amazing.
Here comes Flame Boy.
Destroying all the health.
Thank you. That took a while to clean.
Archfog gets dynamite. So why is the water purple? Ooh, shrooms. Alright, that's cool light. Thanks for chilling.
Hope you have a good night, man. Take care.
Oh shit. That's good to hear, man. Whoa. Look at that, it's like an old tree. Whole texture just made for that. Holy shit. I needed that. So much effort put into this mod, it's so crazy. Oh, it's because of that torch. Not really working if you're too close to the wall. Oh, sweet. are we? That's how quickly the dynamite kills the Slybee. Supposed to be a lily pad? Fuck. Ow. The thing I just saved. Dead. Ooh, spinach, I needed that. Now we can go back to full 200-200. Oh God. That was a freaking genius level. Stronghold. Ah, finally some brightness. Oh. Pinkies with pants. still one of the best additions. Oi. This looks so nice. I like how it's like floating into the ground underwater. I've forgotten the person who made this again. Someone called Arch. Also known as Darch. Paradoom and Preacher he also made. Haven't I played that? Oh, I have seen gameplay of it actually, now that I'm looking at it. It's also pretty good. Evil Journey, bro. I might look up more of their stuff. This person makes very good quality Doom maps. The weird ass plant. Holy fuck, a new type of imp. They throw dynamite. Dangerous. They also drop dynamite, which is good. Steampunk arachnotrons. Did I just get head scanned by something? Stop traveling across the map! Another dynamite thrower. And I have to watch out for them because they look so similar to normal imps. It's got different clothing. I knew it. Knew he'd be in there. Oh shit. Oh shit. Oh my god. Even air targets work with the dynamite launcher. Oh shit! Someone's tossing dynamite at me! Where's this son of a bitch? There he is. Dude, this weapon is so crazy. Okay, we got no blue. Got no blue. Where we get blue? Is that blue? Too many manks. Game is throwing more and more traps at me. Damn it. Goddamn monkey donkeys. Manky tankies. Manka boobs. Oh, we actually got him with that. That's also like infighting. Holy shit. Explosion. Have some ball. Ow. Spinach. Punk. 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 I should have done the alt fire right away. Oh god, a lot of bullets now. There we go. That's how we deal with that.
What's up, Rector?
Did you beat it yet? Ancient Gods 2? Better have your pleb. It's going good. Playing Pirate Doom, one of the best freaking WADs I've ever played in my life. Well, I hope you enjoyed yourself. I did a nightmare run myself last night. Really enjoyed it. There were a lot of people who had very strong criticisms against the DLC, and they personally didn't bother me too much, but I can definitely see their point of view, and I think, you know, a lot of the criticisms are valid. Just that most of the complaints really didn't really bother me myself, but the DLC could have been better if, you know, a lot of the criticisms got addressed. Yeah, with the way it ended, it pretty much leaves... I mean, I'm not gonna spoil anything for Ogryth, but it leaves it open for anything to happen, right? I like how, again, they did the what mod does no one use, let's make an enemy that requires that mod thing. I agree. Strongly agree with that. They did it twice. With the Gatling shotgun, but also kind of with the remote detonation rockets. I found myself using a lot more remote detonation. So I'm a big fan of that. Yeah, it works very well. But in general, because of like videos Under the Mayo was making regarding falters and stuff, I found myself using a lot more remote detonation in this DLC. Although I would occasionally still switch to salvos, lock-ons, but the falters were very useful. But the new weapon is pretty OP. I think most people can agree how OP the new weapon is. But thankfully, you know, an easy remedy for that is to not use the OP weapon. That's why I don't use the BFG and Unmaker anymore, because I find those OP as well, so I just don't use them. Ever since I started the second Ancient Gods, I just started, like, not using. No, I think actually before that, I just don't use BFG and Unmaker. I found myself just not being as satisfied when I use it. I also don't pick up any extra lives anymore. Because I have the same feeling when I, like, get through a fight and it uses an extra life. I just do not feel the satisfaction at the end of the fight. And if I'm gonna replay Ancient Gods 2, I'm definitely not gonna use the hammer. Unless they nerf it, of course. Which they might. Yeah, it's fine. Play in whatever way you want. That's why I think it's better that there are overpowered weapons rather than underpowered ones, and the underpowered ones, well, not necessarily underpowered, but like less popular ones get to see more use. But if there's like overpowered weapons, well, then you always have the freedom to just not use them. So that's what I'm doing. I still gotta play the Super Gorness Monster level. I haven't played it yet. But I think I'm ready for it because I'm like back up. Like I'm in my game again with like Doom Eternal, because at the beginning I was sucking ass because I had to get used to everything again. Hello, Mank. Meet Dynamite. This weapon is totally broken. so hard to aim with this cannon because it gives you like such a bright flash that you can't really see where the hell you're landing, so you can't really correct your shots that much. Awkward. Can I also use the elevator? Thank you. Ah! Fuck. I didn't save all my all level shit. One of those moments again. What's this to do again? I have no idea. Oh god. Those dudes throw dynamite. Homing suicide parrots, watch out. Oh god. I don't have any dynamite. Jeez, map is a lot tougher. So what exactly is Grog? Wait, are Arachnotrons Grogs? Cause this looks like the Arachnotron factory. Oh god, no. Gee, if only the platforms I make in my levels looked as good as these. Too bad the ammo fell down there. Could have used some more dynamite. Yeah, we got the key. Oh hey, friends. That zombie man got absolutely blasted in the face. Ah, god. Wanna go in here? Just want to kill the chain gunner. God. Damn it. Where is it? Just going circles up. I guess grog is some kind of fuel. Because the Mank carry a grog barrel on their back. And arachnotrons are made here, so I guess, you know, they use fuel. How's a grog barrel? Why am I such an idiot who keeps dying? Oh. bastard. There he is. Red. Green. Dangerous. This is a big no-no spot. Check out how these scripts are made. Spider-Mama gonna be like a big version of this. I'm gonna see the Spider-Mama. I keep asking myself, how will this mod keep topping itself? How will it keep showing me new interesting things with the amount of amazing things it's already shown me? But it doesn't stop. The mod doesn't stop showing me amazing things. Eternal Pirate Doom. Why would you wanna cross something so amazing with something so bad? Create like a freaking nuclear bomb by doing that. Because the amount of contradiction seems to, like, too broken. Including you. Seems. I got stuck in the window. Fucking stabbed. In a wholesome way. How does the world burn in a wholesome way? Does that work?
Wholesome world burnings.
The more I play this, the more worried I get. About the WADs that are next after this. Ugh. LeChuck's hideout. Who's LeChuck? Danger. No one beyond this point. Literally no one, not even the person who wrote that. Pretty sure they're beyond this point. No trespassing. Violators will be shot. Survivors will be shot again.
That was in GTA, I believe, I said you or something.
On the loading screen. Oh god. I think I'm gonna have trouble with that. Big trouble with that. Yeah. I had enough trouble with back, or not back, I was Stardate. And now we're gonna have more troublesome things. Oh, Kakko got squished. Fuck, it only takes one dynamite. Too bad they didn't align the textures there. A quick playthrough. Do that. Then you'll be knowing like what's to come for me. So you can be all excited if there's gonna be something bad for me in store. Flew away pretty aggressively. Gimps, yes. There is a new enemy in Doom Eternal that got nicknamed the Simp. The Simp. S-I-M-P. But Strunky, aren't you not allowed to say that word on Twitch?
Yeah, it's pretty ridiculous that Twitch is going so far to just ban
those kind of words. I mean, you know, there's plenty of words that definitely are rightfully banned. But holy fuck, stuff like simp or even virgin, like, Jesus Christ. There was also a third one, right? Simp, virgin, and incel. I mean, there was an info, I didn't grab it. Yeah, but that's the thing, you know. They banned one word. You know, simp is like a pretty modern word, right? It's like a modern insult. It's like they're gonna come up with new words anyway, so like what the fuck is the problem, you know? Like, and they're gonna just end up banning that word. Just makes no sense. You can keep banning words, but it's just, you know, it's just useless. Super dumb on Twitch indeed. Ah, you know what? I could have used the Archval's jumps to grab these things. Pretty sure that was what I was supposed to do. Oh well. Ow! I can grab them now. That was a barrage of arachnotrons, I think. There we go. No! Thank you. Now die! Is a bit tough. But where's all the revs at now? Oh, there they are. Ow, you dick! Homing parrots, suicidals. Yeah, suiciding homing parrots. What the fuck is that?
Now you're gonna get it.
We're back in the first level. Captain Pleb. Guess it's LeChuck. They're throwing the Warrens at me. Okay, he didn't even attack. Sometimes archfiends are like instant attack. Sometimes they just keep running and running and like, I don't feel like attacking. But you know what, I feel like eating a sandwich. Man, I wouldn't mind some whiskey right about now. Oh god. Oh god. Well, my health got deleted quickly. Wait, that's the exit? That can't be. I need all three keys for the actual exit, right? That can't be the exit. This looks good. Oh, we got all three. Jeez, sweet. missing plank.
It's not over yet, Snake.
A lot of stuff. I have no idea if this is the last level.
Now you're gonna get it,
Captain Pleb. What, Chuck? Big head mode activate. Head becomes lost soul. Hope to see a health meter. Lost souls. I got killed by LeChuck. I'm gonna assume this is the final boss. Just spam the TNT. Easy.
Game over.
Epilogue. So LeChuck, the cuck, the ghost pirate, was behind it this whole time. Using evil voodoo magic, he had turned all pirates into demons. Now that he is defeated, they are changing back to their true forms. So the pirates become pirates again, and are also unfriendly.
Anyway, how is your sex life?
At least the ones you didn't kill are too many to speak the truth. Pirate Doom. Oh, gold. We got a lot of cool commands. I still need to add a lot of nice ones. Got so much money, it's embarrassing. When is it embarrassing to have a lot of money? Guess unless you're Bobby Kotick, maybe. Thank you, I thought I was doomed. Thanks to you, I won't have to marry that evil, foul-smelling, vile scallywag, evil sack of scum, and codependent villain LeChuck. Jesus. Aye aye, Captain. Too bad we can't kill him. My beer. Give me all your beer. All your beer. Minecraft Doom? Wait, what? Yeah, this is gold, right? Oh, I don't know what these are. Crystals of some kind. You can stand on them. Ah. Mining with a sword. Who's this? Thanks for not killing me, matey. Kinda do want to kill him. Exit. Oh, X marks the spot. Are you feeling the smell?
That smelly smell. That smelly smell.
Anchovies. Secret is revealed. Heh, the dead ones didn't change back. Don't worry, I won't tell anybody.
Surprise, motherfucker!
All the dead. Dead pirates remain dead. Ah. Oh, yeah, I didn't have any more, TNT. This was fun, this was great. Zero complaints, easy 10 out of 10 WOD. I loved this. I loved every moment of this WOD. So much love and care put into this, so much creativity. There's not a single map that feels bland. Every map just had a good idea. It's full of charm, full of just character, and yeah, this is awesome. Highly recommend Pirate Doom to everyone. We can take a look at all the... Like, just the sprite reworks are very nice. Very nicely done. Drunk Pirate, Shotgun Pirate. He's got a beard. Gatling Gun Pirate. He's got a wooden leg. Imp. Demon with pants. I mean, a pinky with pants, come on. Why hasn't anyone thought about this earlier? Lost soul. Kaka demon with a bandana. Absolutely gorgeous. Just look how cute! Hell sailor. Hell Knight with tattoos and shit and an eye patch, of course. Baron of the Seven Seas. The names are even great. Pyrechnotron. I love that. Oh, even now it's making me laugh with the amazing puns. Elemental. And sideburns. Witch Doctor. Spider Monster Pirate. I love these sprites. Cyber Pirate. Look at the cyber leg, it's like a pirate leg. I didn't even notice that. Yeah, amazing.
Amazing.
One of my favorite WODs of all time, absolutely. No questions asked. I loved every bit of it. And yeah, I'm gonna call it a night. Thank you guys for coming over and chilling. I appreciate it. And oh yeah, I should like write some notes down. I'm just gonna do 10 out of 10 easy. A pirate themed wad full of creativity, charm, love and care. Not a single moment was enjoyed every single moment of it from start to end. Not a single never stops impressing me. And always kept coming up with new surprises and ways to make me laugh. One for the books. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. One of the best WoDs I've ever played. I definitely want to like look up the maker's other projects, because I've seen he made other stuff. It's just other perfection. Like, just not as... like, you'd think it's like an official expansion. Stuff like, you know, Duke Caribbean and stuff. It's just crazy. Alright. I wish you all a good night. Thank you again for chilling. And I will see you guys tomorrow with another stream. You guys take care.